Well, because today is important because it like brings attention, I think, not just to independent record stores, because a lot of mainstream releases get released at record store day now, but it brings attention to physical music, which I think is extremely important.
Record store day means everything to me. It's like Christmas, and I get to meet all these people I only see once a year, and we have like a yearly catch-up. It's fantastic.
I didn't really want to ruin it for myself by clicking the list. Can you see?
Bloody decent work. John,
I'm just filming it. The thing I want to try and do is make the actual experience of queuing up, yeah. not like, oh my god, I've got to queue up, make it fun and whatever.
Take a slice, pass it on.
Oh, thank you!
Best record of the day ever!
It's 10 o'clock on Record Store Day Eve, the night which is, as we know, way more exciting than Christmas Eve. To put this into context, this time last year the first people got to the queue at about 10:30. It's now earlier than that and the queue's around the corner. Really good vibe, people are making friends. It's a good fun time, and Record Store Day again is looking like a busy old day for us. There's so many different people, so many different types of music fans buying so many different types of records, and even the people who got here last night buying records, queuing up for hours, all buying different types, but all buying different types of records, different types of music, but all uniting, and friends were made. And, you know, it's a cute thing to watch and be a part of.
I never knew about this day until not that long ago, so yeah, I really like it.
Just supporting Banquet as a record store, a label, and all of the other things that they do, really.
Very excited. I've come to get the 1975 EPs and I've been waiting since 9 o'clock.
We're here to check out the exclusive, and Record Store Day is just a good place to get some exclusive stuff on vinyl. She doesn't want to blow it. Shifting at the table, you left her need to show me around. Quickens your heartbeat, me straight into the ground. You don't recover from a night like this. A victim still lying in bed, completely motionless. I had slipped in the dark to a zip. Hear a boy bass and tight against sheets, barely whisper. This is so messed up. Upon arrival, the guests had all stared. Dripping wet and clear, depressed, he'd headed straight for the stairs. No longer cool, but a boy in a stare.
First one, never done it before. 4 hours queuing, but got some stuff. Quite exciting.
I think they sound the best, and it's nice to have a physical format of things instead of, I guess maybe downloading music on your phone is easier, but it's more special and it's a lot more interesting and it's nice to collect.
It was really good. It was my first time coming, and so it was a really good experience. I kind of wish I got here earlier though, like for the proper experience, but I had a nice time.
Yeah. It's all. Yeah, no, I don't know any of this.
There you go, another great record store day. Long may it continue. We've seen a few things recently, a few naysayers about record store day, but I think today has given us more proof of how great a day is, how much it brings people together. We're so excited to be a part of it year in, year out.
You know, a lot of indie labels are talking about frustrations with the pressing plants and not being able to get records back and being kind of brushed aside by the majors. So that they can, you know, get those big quantities of record store day stock orders back. The time when we're celebrating vinyl and celebrating record shops really kind of selling both major label and indie label music is a time when some of those labels can't actually press the vinyl that they want to put into the shops. There is a flip side to that. There's a lot of indie label representation today on record store day, and a lot of very decent, you know, very decent releases that people were, you know, super excited for, as much as the label, major label stuff.
The whole key thing for Record Store Day is the celebration of physical music, how you buy it, and the interactions between us as a business and a group of friends, and customers and a group of friends. Like, it's been a real good vibe, and long may that continue.
In the queue today, there were two girls, I guess they were 14 or 15, in 1975 t-shirts, queued for about 3 hours just to pick up, you know, the 1975 records, which, yeah, that's great to see, and like, it's one of the first times they've been in the store, and you know, that's a major label record they're buying, but it's, you know, it's the step, the bridge, getting them into the shop. It's those things bringing people into the shop and bringing the new blood into the shop, and yeah, we're obviously all for that.
For Kingston, it's a great event in itself, the amount of people travelling far and wide to visit like an independent record shop in South West London. It's a great time. It brings people into Kingston, and I think everyone can benefit from the fact that we've got like a vibrant music scene here. So anyway, that's our little rockumentary about Record Store Day 15 this year. Blah, 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 industry, sales, whatever, whatever. But the fact is, Record Store Day is about getting records. And these are what I got this year. This is Real Friends. They're a band who, I love them. Their ideas, me, pop punk. And this is an acoustic EP. They played acoustic for us recently. Love them. Two 1975 singles. I think they're both real new slang moments of the last couple of years. I went for Now One. It's a great Fun Times album from the 80s reissued onto vinyl, and this Maccabees is one of my all-time favourite albums. Never seen it on record until today. I had to wait until all the people who were in the queue got in first, and then I took mine, and I'm stoked on it. So that's the important thing.